Now with a very special presentation is an engineer who has worked with a long list of Grammy Award-winning artists, including George Benson, Aretha Franklin, Santana, and Whitney Houston. She is also the senior managing director of the producer and engineers wing of the Recording Academy, as well as an author and recording educator on the subject of recording. Please welcome Maureen Droney.
Thank you, Fred. And I listened to what he said, and this is engineer dress up. Engineer dress up. I am so thrilled to be here to honor two of our behind-the-scenes industry titans. In preparing for this moment, I wanted to focus on what makes them unique. With Dave and mixing, one of the things that makes him so special and what moves him is his love of art. From the rule of thirds to the golden triangle to painters like Diego Velázquez and Van Gogh, Dave brings that understanding of craft along with all of his musical experiences to his daily work. With Herb, he's such a great manager and teacher, in part because of the breadth and depth of his knowledge. The range of his expertise goes way beyond our industry, to the West African poets, musicians, and storytellers called griots, and Clive Davis too. But the real reason I'm here, the reason I love them so much, is they both really believe and live by such ideas as niceness matters, and if you want to do something, make it as good as you possibly can. Those are quotes from the book I wrote with them about the place that is earning them a spot in the NAMM TEC Hall of Fame. Of course, I'm talking about Pensado's place. When these two men joined forces in a new medium, they created a remarkable new career. So let's take a look at a show I never miss.
Dave plays it straight. Herb is dynamic, and together, what they've created is the perfect mix. Something they both know a lot about, sound. And nobody would have predicted that what they created would become a remarkable online place for the world of music. The most watched pro audio show on the web. During the past decade, they've gone from YouTube sensation to a multimedia powerhouse. A show that is based on who can't say no to being on their show because it is prestigious all over the world. It all began in 2011 when legendary mixer Dave Pensado and artist manager Herb Trawick created a new web series, Pensado's Place. Neither could have imagined that by the close of the decade, what they had started on a shoestring would evolve into a wildly popular show, one that is seen by over 6 million people every year. And that's no exaggeration. The show pops up on computer screens and iPhones in over 200 countries and is part of the curriculum in more than 100 colleges and universities.
Pensado, thinking. Good.
Dave Pensado is one of the recording industry's preeminent mix engineers, who at one time mixed more than 200 songs a year. After 4 nominations, he finally won a well-deserved Grammy for Mary J. Blige's Growing Pains. Dave trained in Atlanta in the 80s by working with acts like Cameo and James Brown. After moving to LA in the 90s, he's gone on to work with a host of superstars like Pink, Beyoncé, Christina Aguilera, will.i.am, Frank Ocean, Kelly Clarkson, and Michael Jackson. Dave somehow found the time to write 2 books and is the leading audio educator on the planet, speaking at schools and conferences everywhere. Herb Trawick, the creator, executive producer, and co-host of Pensado's Place, is also an industry veteran, a winner of BRE's Manager of the Year Award, as well as being inducted as Creative Visionary Executive into the Living Legends Foundation. Herb is perhaps best known for helping guide Brian McKnight to R&B superstardom. Herb's first big gig was as a marketing executive at Solar Records. He also ran imprints and had consultancies at Interscope, RCA, Mercury, Motown, and Virgin Records. Working closely with the group's founder, the late, truly great Maurice White, Herb became a partner in Earth, Wind & Fire's catalog, taking them to Broadway as a producer of the play Hot Feet. Baby, when you dance with these, I'll give you hot feet. Together, Dave and Herb bring their vast pro experience to every episode, as each week producers and engineers, mastering and mixing mavens, studio collaborators with artists from Coldplay to Kanye, Keith Urban to Tool, Bruno Mars to Post Malone, join them to talk all things audio. And my heart. Remains true to his vision. Dave's favorite part is sharing his incredible depth of knowledge. Nothing is better than being able to teach, says Pensado. The ability to share and watch it positively impact a life is incredibly powerful. It's that ethos that makes Dave so revered by his peers and a legend to his fans. And it is a testament to his partner Herb's influence and imagination that Pensado's Place has become such a powerful and educational tool to so many audio lovers all over the world. For their unparalleled contribution to music education and the true appreciation of the sound of music, we are proud to welcome Dave Pensado and Herb Trawick and Pensado's Place to a well-deserved place in the NAMM TEC Hall of Fame. And we
I'm so proud to be the one who gets to induct Dave Pensado and Herb Trawick into the NAMM TEC Hall of Fame.
I have no clue how I got here, none whatsoever. I've done just about everything wrong a person can do in my life, and somehow I find myself in front of you guys, which is a great honor. You know, sometimes we forget about NAMM and some of the things they do to help our industry, and so I'd like to take a moment just to say thank you for all the things you do to help keep the industry propped up, enhanced, and growing all the time. I'd like to thank all the people that have helped put the show together and keep the show going. We've had tremendous staffs and people that, that really gave a lot to the show, and without those people, the show couldn't go on. Also, the guests. We've been blessed that they've enjoyed coming on the show and do a lot of extra things for the show, so thank you to those two groups. And then, I don't want to get emotional, so I'm going to do this real quick. I want to thank my partner and friend and mentor and mentee and just I wouldn't be here without Herb Trawick. There's no question. There's no maybe, no nothing. If you're good with math, you know that I wouldn't be here without Herb. I always knew I was going to be in music. My mother was gifted, and I never had an option to not be in music. So I always knew I'd be here, but it never dawned on me that I could engineer, and it never dawned on me that I would be successful at anything in the engineering world. So that's a wonderful thing. And then who knew that I could be a broadcaster, you know? Well, maybe I'm not a broadcaster. That might be a little bit of an exaggeration, but... I've always felt like the next best thing to doing music is talking about it, so I guess that's where all of that comes from. I'm so proud of the show. I'm so happy that that we've maintained our standards and been an asset to the community, and with your help and your support, I think we can keep going forever. I want to thank all the people at NAMM and the Tech Awards for this honor. I'm humbled, especially when I see Joni Mitchell in the audience and the Ventures, all these people that I have an amazing respect for. Just being in the room with you people is an honor. And then at the same time, thank you so much to the Tech Awards for this award. And I'll never let you down, so thank you so much.
You good? You said a lot of what I was going to say. First of all, I want to thank the band, and particularly the horn section, for sticking Keep on Trucking. The horn section nailed that. I think Dave and I's careers are split into BPP and APP, which is before Pensado's Place and after Pensado's Place. To the incredible staff at NAMM, Joe, you run an incredible organization, and Zach and Pete and Andy and Shalice and Karen and Jessica. By the way, if there's any professional basketball fans, Karen Dunn can talk hoops like the best of them. She can go short corner three, you know, backdoor lob. We watched many a game on television together. BPP, before Pensado's Place, you know, there's hundreds of names. We've had a very lucky career and worked very hard at it. But I just want to point out two. One is my dear friend and just brilliant horsepower brain, and he's been with me since I came out here in 1978, and he's sitting at table 26 with me now. His name is Virgil Roberts. Virgil. Means a lot. And his lovely wife and equally brilliant Brenda. And then the other name, BPP, would be Maurice White. Hard to imagine that Maurice was very reclusive, very guarded. And the fact that he felt comfortable with me being part of his team, and we spent so much time on philosophy and showmanship and all kinds of stuff. Life-changing moments. One day we were coming home, and he said, he was looking at me while we were listening to music. And he said, "Man, you listen like me. You listen like a musician." And if I never got another accolade in music ever in life, I'll take that and think it was amazing. Then there's APP, which is after Pensado's Place. It starts with Dave, his Rolodex, the respect of his peers, and his kind of interesting Uncle Festus meets audio brilliance way of talking. I mean, we tease him on the team and lovingly call him the Joe Biden of audio. But sheer insight, absolute brilliance. It makes me, as a co-host, have to be on my toes because Dave will say some stuff that's just, like, I think the third show on air, he said, "I haven't had this much fun since a pig ate my brother." And I had to recover from that, but we've gotten better at it now. Keep staying original, man. Couple other groups, sponsors. We've never had a sales team. We don't handle people for money. We have an expensive production, and you guys have stepped up year after year and allowed us to go with our craziness and create Cap Jam and Mix Fest and Gear Expo and the Pensado Awards and all kinds of things. As he said, our guests, every category, legends, artists, hip hop, pop, EDM, streamers, Netflix has come on, you tech companies, Google, Facebook, the fact that they find value in it is amazing. You also mentioned our team. To all those who went before us, and I'll wrap up in a second, for all those who went before us, thank you, but the team that we have now, run by ladies, who are absolutely, is the best team we've ever had. Yeah. Super, super, super talented. Couldn't be prouder of you guys. And finally, when I got the call, I'm not generally speechless. The thing that I couldn't stop thinking about was actually Ed Turney.
Yeah.
He was a great friend to us. We worked together when we honored Drew Swedien. We interviewed him at the Grammy party when he had his knee replaced. I remember I wanted Rose on the show, and Rose was very very shy. And so she cut a deal with me, and she said, I'll go on if I can sit beside you and you hold my hand underneath the desk. And we got Paula on and Zoe and got her girls on with her. So I called Ed and said, I have to touch your wife under the desk for the show. And classic Ed said, oh, she'll like it. You probably do it better than I do. I think with all those one-name people in the hall, Quincy, Al, the Phils, Rose, so many people, and of course Ed, the fact that Dave and Herb's one names could be part of this, it's pretty cool, yeah. Don't you think?
Yeah.
So, thanks. I was really cool till the video backstage. I was like, oh my God, I'm tearing up. I'm being such a wuss. Bottom line, and as we go, this is because of all your gifts. We always looked at audio as much bigger than most people look at it. The brilliance in this room is unbelievable between your tools and your talents and your abilities. We're glad we ripped the scab off and that the world knows how bad you are, and keep pushing, and we'll keep pushing, and we're gonna keep on going, and Dave and I and our team are extremely, extremely humbled to be part of the Tech Hall of Fame. Thanks, everybody.